Hello, one and all. Welcome to this edition of Kitz Corner, and welcome to, I guess, part two of the expose into verified.me, this government now tool of suppression and tool of security and surveillance being implemented by major banks, being implemented by other government organizations and other corporations to harvest information on you, to use at their whims to manipulate you and to try to control you. And I know it sounds very far-fetched. I know it sounds like something complete hyperbole, but if you go and look at the first video that we did about this, if you go look at the TD breakdown when they announced this in their banking services, this is happening. And they've hinted about this. We've heard, you know, theories. We heard conversations about this. And guess what? It's happening. And it's downright disturbing. It is downright disturbing. And it is so absurd and so mind-boggling that someone like me has to be the voice to tell you this, because you're not hearing this from any publication or any news outlets, at least here in Canada, about this digital ID surveillance tool and just how sinister it can get. So obviously this is about verified.me. We've shown how it's linked to all these major banks. And again, they're trying to sell it in the form of convenience and security, and it's going to be beneficial to your lifestyle. Well, now they've implemented a commercial for this, and I thought I'd take a moment to show this commercial to you and also just show how creepy this can get and how they tried to sway your persuasion of giving corrupted government institutions your information, because we know how authoritarian they can get when it comes to freezing bank accounts of people, individuals, as they're protesting the mandates, as they're protesting the tyranny of the government, as they're exercising their freedom of speech and their freedom of assembly. We know how corrupted government institutions can get when it comes to stuff like this. That is why this is such a big deal. But watch how easily they make this commercial sound pleasant of giving away this information to a bunch of unruled, crazy, unethical elitists that are going to take control over you. Look at this.
Today, verifying who you are online can be hard. It sometimes takes too long, and you may have to share too much information. Many sites want a username and password, sometimes even selfies or pictures of our driver's license, and you may have to wait days or weeks to be verified. There has to be a better way, and now there is. Verified Me is the new and secure.
There has to be a better way. There has to be an accessible way for the government to reign authority over you. There has to be a better way for the private citizen to have all of its information being sent up to a criminal class of elites. There's got to be a simpler way. I love how even in the beginning, they mentioned about how it's too much information to give to one company. But now, because of this verified.me and how connected it is to other entities, even more corrupted than one corporation. I love how they're stating that, you know, a password or anything like, oh, you're giving so much information away. So the best solution in their eyes is to get more information to a bunch more people. Anyway, there's more to this.
Secure Canadian service that helps you verify your identity so you can get things done quickly online, in person, and on the phone. Verification is based on information you've already shared with organizations you trust, like your financial institution. Meet Alana. Alana has a lot on the go. She works long hours and juggles a busy lifestyle. Her time is valuable. It's inconvenient for her to compile lots of documents and go in person to register for services she should be able to conveniently arrange online or over the phone. She wants to get things done fast and with Verified Me.
Which, by the way, we've been doing it already. We've been doing this already. We have online banking. We have a system already in place. Why do you need to have this verification service when we already can implement online transactions? Like, it's so amazing that they're trying to make this sound like it's a simple process, but really you're just adding an extra step to a situation that didn't even need an extra step. Like, is anyone else, like, not just absurd by this? Like, how stupid this sounds? Oh, it's making it more simple because you have a busy lifestyle and you can't go out and interact with people. You can't, you know, do all this stuff yourself. Like, just, it's so absurd.
She can. Alana is thinking of making a big purchase and wants to check her credit score. She simply connects a credit bureau to her Verified Me profile and is then able to quickly get the information she needs.
Oh my God.
Alana wants to register to use her insurance provider's website and mobile app. Using Verified Me, she authorizes her financial institution to share the requested information privately and securely with the insurance company, and she is able to register quickly. With Verified Me, Alana can safely and securely link new connections to her profile quickly and share her personal information from those connections to help verify her identity right from her smartphone. Verified Me brings it all together.
Is it just me? Is it just me? Or every time I hear about verifying identity, like, it just makes me think of all the pronoun stuff. Like, is that the whole purpose of this? Because we live in an age where, you know, we have non-binary, we have gender fluid, and we have all this stuff, which, again, I'm not dissing the trans community. I support them as much as any other person. I will fight and support for basic human rights as any other individual. I'm not dissing those people. But it just seems like in this landscape, in the era that we're in right now, it just seems like all we're talking about is identifying people. Which I thought we've already covered, that like it's already a common practice. Like, we know how to do that. We don't need a government-issued surveillance tool to verify people. Like, it's just so stupid. It literally is just so stupid. And all it really is a gateway access for corrupted government officials to have access over your account and can decide things for you. Because at the whim of a button, at the whim of a code, the whim of a switch or anything, they can decide whether you have a bank account. They can decide if you get life insurance. They can decide if you'll get that purchase. Because if they were able to freeze the bank accounts and attack GoFundMe and attack the people that were supporting the GoFundMe, imagine how much influential power they'll have with this. Because now you're giving them more authority to do this. And they're selling it on the point of convenience. Like, somehow it's more convenient to put more information to another company so that somehow you can avoid the little things. Like, again, I just don't understand this world. I don't understand this.
It's that simple. Verified Me is a service offered by Secure Key Technologies, Inc. The Verified Me service was
which we uncovered in the last video, is a government-issued company. They were coordinating directly with the government of Canada. Directly. So this is a security tool used by the government. This is a surveillance tool. This is not some independent organization that decide, hey, we need to make things easier for people. No, this is the government that came up with this and implemented this over a decade ago and then used the opportunity of COVID, the opportunity of the trucker convoy, the opportunity of, hey, we can implement our own mandates, and we can decide people if they'll have bank accounts and decide their fate and decide their lifestyle. Because now we have more information. We have more information on private citizens than we do about our own government. That's the backwards, upside down, crazy world that we live in. That they're trying to have control over you. Because once they have control over you, they can have control over society. They can have control over culture. They can have control over everything. That's why they're doing this. That's why they're implementing more censorship tactics. Because they want domination over individuals. They don't trust us. They fear us. Because they know if we can get together and unite on common fronts and common foundations, we are more powerful than they are. So that's why they're doing shit like this and doing it in shady ways by telling the banks that they have to implement this to the customers and then say, well, you have the option to opt out, but you won't be able to use our bank.
Developed in cooperation with seven of Canada's major financial institutions, BMO, CIBC, Desjardins, National Bank of Canada, RBC, Scotiabank, and TD. Along with our innovation partners, using strong security protocols and having privacy at the core. The Verified Me network continues to evolve with new identity providers and service providers joining frequently to make your life easier. With Verified Me, your personal information is never shared without your consent. You always stay in control by choosing when to share.
Now, they just said your information is not shared without your consent. But what about their consent? Because I gave them the power to take that information. So how do I know that they're being secure with my information? Because they won't. Because then they'll use it and sell it off to other pieces of the establishment. You do realize this is a one big giant password machine that you're selling off to every other organization. At least when you create 50 different accounts, I know it's stressful, but I create an account directly to that person, directly to that one organization. What you're doing here is trying to blanket so that everybody I interact with, all the basic services, all your, you know, finances, your healthcare, your education, your government services, driver's licenses, the service on, like, blanketed with this one verified.me account that the government has access to. That's like, it's disturbing. And how do I know that's safe? It's not. Because you're giving that information to a bunch of corrupted criminals that have done unethical things against people with their own information. We know this already.
Share your information and with whom, reducing oversharing of personal information in order to access the services you want. Verified Me, your identity in your control.
Oh my God. Oh my God. So there you go, folks. That is literally Orwell in an application, ladies and gentlemen. Because while they say it's your identity in your control, who is in control of the application? Who are the heads creating this application? Who are you exactly giving this information to? As you just saw there, Verified.me is a product child of SecureKey. SecureKey is a government co-opted company. So government institutions, corporations align themselves together, which in my view is the definition of fascism. And in the cases of what the definition of fascism is, it's kind of accurate. That we have governments, corrupted governments, align themselves with corrupted corporations to then use the tool of surveillance to track, to monitor, and to manipulate individuals and their free will. This is literally, truly fascism of the 21st century. And it's being implemented here in Canada. As much as any other country that's happening right now. I know UK is doing this. I know parts of the US is trying to convey this up. They're, India, Afghanistan, basically any aligned country with the World Economic Forum is going to be on board with this. Because this is their movement. This is what the World Economic Forum proposed. That wouldn't be so great if we had this one application that had all the information of one individual, and then we could decide how we can control that individual. It sounds like I'm talking about a Sims game, but you know, in when billionaires are in control of you. This is not good, folks. This is not good, folks. And the fact that no media organization, no outlet, no publication is bothering to mention this, except for people like me, is even more disturbing.